Hey guys, welcome back to another video of Creatnprocess. In this video, we'll be designing a print-ready business card in Illustrator. There are a few things that's really important to know before you start designing for print. The first thing is to understand its standard dimension. So for business card, the standard dimension is 3.5 by 2 inches. In millimeter, it's 90 by 51 millimeter. The second thing is to leave bleed area. It's really important. We'll discuss about this as we go further. The third and most important thing is to design your project in CMYK color mode, because the standard color mode used by printers is CMYK. So if your design is going to print it out, make sure you choose CMYK. Now let's get back to Illustrator and set up a new document. So file, new, and we got a document box here. Let's give a name. So let's give BUSINES business, and we'll give the number of artboard to 2, and we'll change the units to millimeter, and we'll give the spacing around 30 mm, and let's give the width and height. So we have the width 90 by 51, and let's give bleed around 3 mm, and this is for from all side, and there is the extra space for design element on the background. So, and under advanced, we'll choose the color mode to CMYK, our raster effects to high 300 pixel per inches, and click OK. So we got this file, and now our file is open with two artboards for both front and back. We have got this red box. So this is the bleed area. The business card with bleed is printed out slightly oversized and then cut down to its original size. So it's really helps. So let's add our save zone area. So I'll use the ruler to create that, control R, and let's bring out the ruler. So we'll give the save zone around 5 mm from all sides. So from here we'll give 5 mm from here, again 5 mm from here, 5 if I see here, so this is the 5 mm, and here also we'll put that. So I choose and just place it there. In the same way, we'll put here also. So I'll just drag out, and if I see here, this is the 5 mm, and from here also we'll put the 5 mm here. So from all the sides, we have given a sieve zone of 5 mm, and all the design elements like logos and text should be inside this sieve zone so that we don't lose anything. So now let's create our logo first. So I have to create a logo for this design. So I'll use the rectangle tool and create out a square. And after that, let's fill this up with a simple blue color. And now we'll do the designing part. Next thing we need to do is we need to just combine few stuff. So I'll just select hold this row and just go to Pathfinder and just combine it, mean one object. Select these three pieces, combine it, and here we go. So we got three different shapes here. And now let's fill this up with the proper color. So I have already prepared my CMYK color for this design. So let's apply that. And I'll select this gradient tool, apply a gradient color, and first on the gradient slider, I just select CMYK, and this time let's fill this up with the gradient color. For the CN, I'm going to put 71, magenta 23, and yellow and krypton remain 0. And for the second slider, I'll just select, double click on that, make it CMYK, and let's fill up the color. So for the CN, it's 98, magenta is 73. And yellow is 10 and krypton is 1. So let's check it out, and that's look. So we have given a nice green color. One side it's light blue and the other side it's dark blue. So let's apply it. So I'll just press this shift and just click and drag to apply it diagonally. So like that, and let's do some adjustment with the slider. So I just bring this together to each other, and this way we'll give some effect here. You can see that, and if you check it out, you can see it's look like there's a banding effect like that. So let's select this and apply the same color with the eye picker. I'll just choose this color from here, and after that I'll just extend this design. Gradient color, just bring it here, and with the gradient tool selected, let's do some adjustments. So like that, Let's give some little like that. And if you move around, you can see that, and you can just play around with these colors and you'll give that nice effect there. In the same way, select this with the eye picker. I select this and apply the same color, and this time let's play around with the color here also, so giving some nice design like that. So once you have given the gradient color, our basic design is ready, and the thing which we are left with is text. So let's apply the text. So I'll just type out text and let's apply the font for this. So selecting this text, I choose a font from here, TWMSenMD. So I'm choosing this, and let's apply a bold one, and let's scale this up. So let's shift pressed, just scale this up, and let's place it along the logo. So we got this logo here, and next thing we need to do is we need to create this business card. So we'll create a background first. So I'll use the rectangle tool and draw a rectangle covering the bleed area. Now let's fill this up with some colors. So I'll just double click on this and let's apply some CMYK colors. So I have one. So for cyan I'll choose 92, for magenta 84, for yellow let's put 51, and for krypton it's 67, and click OK. So we have given a deep blue color here, and in the same way I'll just duplicate this and place it here on the second artboard, and let's lock this and change the color to white. So I choose white color, and selecting these two pieces, Control 2 or Command 2 to lock it. And once you have locked that, let's work out with our design. So I just bring this design here and let's arrange it to front, and after that let's align it with our save zone here, and let's change the text to white, and let's I just duplicate this half piece of the design and place it here, and then just rotate it 180 degrees like that. And after that let's align it with the artboard here like that. Let's zoom it in and let's align it properly like that. Now let's scale this up and properly like that. Okay, once you have done that, let's extend these two pieces until the bleed rectangle. So I'll just use the die selection tool, select these two points here and just drag it out and place it there. Once I have done that, let's work out with our, and let's see, yeah, we can just play around with the size of this logo. So let's make it a little bit bigger or smaller, you can choose that. So now let's duplicate this one more time and place it on the back side of our business card. This is the front and this is the back. So let's change the font color to black, and this time we have to scale this down. So first of all, I'll align this according to our design here on inside the save zone area, and let's scale this down now. So with the shift press, just scale it down and let's see. Yeah, that's great. Or maybe a little bit more smaller like that. Now I'll just duplicate this piece and bring it here, and this time I'll just flip this up. So flipping vertically, okay, and place it accordingly. So I just place it as like this, and let's fill up with the details. So once you have given all details, let's give some symbol for that. So I'll use some symbol from our Windows. So Windows symbol, and here we go. I'll bring out some symbol from the library, and we'll use the web icons. And here we go, we have got a list of icons here. So let's choose perfect icon for each. So for the phone number, I may use this. Okay, this looks great. For the address, let's give some house. For Gmail address, I'll use the message one, and for website, let's choose this. So once you have done that, I'll just close this up and select all these four elements, and I'll just scale this down according to our size. So let's scale this down and let's see. Now let's do our placement. done, we have given all the details here. We have created the front and back, and almost everything is complete. So let's export it out for print. So we'll go to File, Save As, and save it as PDF. So select the PDF and give it a name, business, and let's save it on desktop for a while and save. And the PDF palette will appear here. We'll choose the mark and bleeds, and here let's take the mark, trim mark, so that when you export it out, you got to see the trim mark. And if you want to add color bars, you can, but I think trim mark is okay. And we'll give the offset around 5 mm, so let's give that and save PDFs. So our PDF will be saved and it will open automatically here. So here's the front, back, and it's ready for printing. You just need to connect to your printer and just order to print, and it will print it out, and after that just cut off with the trim mark. And if you want to check out how it's going to look, you can just drag this PDF into your Photoshop and just cut off the edges, and you see how it's going to look, the finished product. Or you can use the mockup and place this design inside a mockup, and this is how it's going to look like. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out our website where I have written a detailed articles on print design. And if you like this video, please like, share and comment. And if you want more updates on designing, press the subscribe button. Thank you.